much. That's all fine. After the Six Wives came Joan, and then came King Arthur, the Misadventures of King Arthur. Now, some interesting things about the King Arthur album, and this is, I suppose, a relatively serious moment. I was ill in 1975. I've been ill ever since, really, but I've been, but I had a bit of a ticker problem. The old heart gave way, and they took me to the hospital, Wexham Park Hospital. It was really funny because me and two other guys in the ward used to climb out the window and go over the red line every night. We were meant to be on strict diets and they couldn't understand how we were putting on weight every day. But that's not the point, very naughty boys were. But while I was in there, this is absolutely true, I'd started writing the King Arthur album. And the old specialist who came round sort of basically said, well, you're going to have to stop working because they didn't really know how to, this was what, 75, they didn't really know what to do with the old heart thing. I mean, now you have a quadruple bypass and you're out the next day playing football for somebody. Back then, they kept me in for 9 weeks. And they said, you can't work anymore, that's it. I thought, I can't do that. That's just impossible. So So I decided to carry on with the album. But what the album became, in many, many respects, was autobiographical. And some of the tracks on there, really, I sort of realised later on that they were as much about me as they were about Arthur. I mean, I was taught by my music teacher to paint pictures, to close my eyes and paint pictures to the music. And it was only when we came to play the King Arthur album, and I'm painting the pictures and I'm seeing the battles and the castle and the things, when it came to, for example, a piece like The Last Battle, I actually saw myself back in Wexham Park Hospital, and that's when I realised that, shit, this is about me. I don't really tell people this before because makes them miserable. but it is interesting when I play this piece. So, but there's one particular piece off the album which was great fun to do, which was Merlin the Magician. And when we recorded it at Morgan Studios, there's a couple of Moog solos. And the problem with solos, if you don't get it right in the first two or three goes, then it feels really good. Then you have to leave it for another day and do it again, because otherwise it starts to become a sort of a staid part. And we were doing Merlin, and I'd had about 2 days at having a go at these solos, and I wasn't really happy with them. And over in the studio across the road at Morgan were Black Sabbath. And Ozzy's a great mate of mine, he said, what you need is drink. So, this is all true. So we were recording it. I said to the guys, look, just finish off the backtrack, you know, fit the backtrack for something else we were doing. I said, I'm just going to go over and have a jar with Ozzy and Tony and Geezer and Bill. And I said, I'll be back in a sec. But the thing to do, and our engineer called Paul Tregurth, I said, Paul, make sure you've got Merlin up ready. I said, because I'm going to come in and I think I'm probably going to have one go at the solo. That's all I'm going to get. He went, why? I said, because I'll be pissed. That's the simple answer to that. And he went, okay, and that's exactly what happened. He did that. I went, I got rat-ass. I blew a bottle of scotch. And I can remember this day going across the road. It was all cold and all that. And I walked in the studio, and I didn't even sound at school, straight over to the Minimo, and which is interesting, it's only like sort of three octaves, but I saw hundreds of them. It was like, and I put the headphones on somehow, and Paul played the track, and I played something, and I passed out. And it was only in the morning that I came, I went, you know, it's not bad, actually. And that's how the little solo became. But again, this whole piece, Merlin, was written just like everything else I did, thanks to Mr. Bowie on the piano. So this is Merlin the Magician. Thank you.